Hi everyone, welcome to the 17th video on Python learning series for network engineers. We will start Netmiko from this video. So in this website you can see some details about Netmiko. The advantage with Netmiko is it simplifies the SSH connection to network device for configuring or executing show commands. This library is particularly for networking devices. So you can see here they're saying multi-vendor library to simplify Paramico SSH connection to network devices. That means it uses Paramico and it makes the communication to network devices easy. There are some dependencies for Netmiko. You can see Paramico is mandatory for Netmiko to work. We have Paramico already installed here. If you want to verify that, you can just type pip list. I'm already into my virtual environment, so you can see here I already have Paramico. In addition to that, some more dependencies are there. Those things it will install automatically once you do the pip install Netmiko. Another interesting thing is textfsm. So textfsm can extract the data from output, the output what we get from device, and convert it into a structured way. In that way we can say it can parse our configuration. We'll be covering those details in upcoming videos, in future videos. So this is the GitHub of Ntc templates. So here you can see there are a lot of templates for networking commands. For example, once you come down to Cisco, you can see in show IP interface brief command, there is a template. So what it does, if you use this template, it gives the output in a structured JSON format and you will be able to read it easily, and you can use the values in other scripts as well. We will see textfsm details later. Now we will move into Netmiko. So the supported devices are listed below. Arista VOS, Cisco ASA, Cisco IOS, XE, XR, NXOS, everything is supported. And they have limited testing on below listed devices and experimental on some more networking devices. And here below you can see some of the examples for Netmiko library, how to use it, how to SSH to a Cisco device and get the output or configure certain things. We'll be referring this script. So before we move into that, we'll install Netmiko. We'll see how to install Netmiko. I'm already into my virtual environment. So here you can see I don't have Netmiko installed. The command is pip install Netmiko. Yeah, it is installing. Yeah, you can see here the packages which it installed, scp, then pyaml, textfsm, everything it installed. Now we'll see one more time pip list. Yeah, you can see I have Netmiko 2.3.3, which is the latest one. Now we'll see the sample script from here. First we need to import a connect handler function. Then we need to create a device dictionary. This is how we need to create a dictionary. It contains a device type, IP address, username, password, port number. So these values are not mandatory. Even in dictionaries, the order is not mandatory. So we'll see some details about that. In device type, this actually they have mentioned and they have defined it in Netmiko library details. So we can see the type of devices it supports in this site. Here Here they will list down all the supported devices and device type details. So you can see here Cisco iOS. You need to give it in same syntax. So based on device type, it will change. You can see the list of devices which supports. So you can see Arista EOS, Cisco NXOS, everything. Now we'll see some of the commonly used methods in Netmiko. So for that, I'll go to pmydoc netmiko. So you can see the packages here. Textfsm is one of the package, and here for handling the error SSH errors, there are classes. So you can see a class called Paramico.ssh exception, which handles exceptions. Even if you get an error from one device, it can continue with another devices if you handle these errors. Then you can get authentication errors. So we'll see those things details in upcoming videos. Another commonly used methods are check config, checks if the device is it is in configuration mode or not. And another method which we commonly use are send command. So here you can see for configuring, for executing the command, for getting the show command output, we use send command method. So they give send command and give the command, they'll get output in this way. Another method is send command timing. So execute command string on SSH channel using delay based mechanism. So you can add delay there. Then send config from file. So that means you can save configuration in a text file, and you can use this method for calling the configuration file. Then send config set means, so you can send a list of command to the device. So even that we can see here. Here you can see a list of commands it is sending using send config set method, which I have shown here. Now we'll start writing code using Netmiko. So in my script folder, I have created a file called 13_netmiko_ssh_py. So here what we'll do, we'll copy from Netmiko import handler and the device dictionary. Then we can change this name rtr_10. And order is not mandatory here. This order, you can even put username on top. We are using default port, so we don't need to use port number. Secret, we don't have enabled password, so we don't need to use secret. And verbose is for detailed logging. We don't have that, so we don't need to use that. If you want, you can just put this on top. So to show order is not mandatory here, I'm just showing this. Yeah, we'll make sure, yeah, it is a 4 spaces, so there should not be an issue. Now before we move into the further configuration here, establishing, we'll see some details about dictionary. Dictionaries consist of key value pairs. I'll show some examples of dictionaries. So if you want to create a dictionary, you can create I'll go to Python interpreter, then I'll create a dictionary called RTR. So it'll be in curly braces. Then I'll create a key called IP. Then I'll give value as 10.10.10.10. Anything we can give here in the value. Enter. Then if I give type of RTR, it'll say this as a dictionary. And if you want to add value to this dictionary, so I'll be adding to the same dictionary. So I need to have RTR, then square bracket, then we'll give a key value as dbase type, then equals, I'll give it as a router, enter. Now if I type RTR, so you can see another value got added here. And if I want to see a particular value of any key, what I need to do, RTR, if I give IP, I'll get the IP address. And if I give device type, I'll get it as router. And order is not mandatory. You can even put device type colon router on first, and still whenever you call a particular key, you will get the value. Now another thing to notice is we'll go to help topics. Here you can see dictionaries. Here you can see multiple examples of creating dictionaries. We used this method. If you're interested, you can explore all the other methods also. Okay, so in that way we have a dictionary here. Now another command is net connect equal to connect handler. So connect handler is a function which we use, so we need to give our dictionary name tr underscore 10. Then another command is going to be show IP interface brief. They are using the method send command and they are printing the output, so we'll use the same. Save the script, we'll try to execute it. We haven't edited the username and password, we need to edit that. Admin password admin. Python. Yeah, we are getting the output here. If you change the command to any other show command, show spanning tree, there is a syntax error in the command, so we'll change that. Spanning tree, we'll execute again. Yeah, so we are getting the output from the device. Now if you want to push the configuration to the device, we need to use net connect dot send config set. So we'll copy this. I'll put it here. here we'll change the command to interface loopback 0 IP address 1.1.1.1.2582 no shutdown, then we'll give show IP interface brief, save the command. So before that we'll SSH to device and see the interfaces. I don't have any interface now. So here you can see they have created a list called config commands, and then they are using the method called send config set and calling the list, and line by line it executes the commands on device. We'll try to execute the script now. It configured, and you can see the loopback interface in my show IP interface brief output. Yeah, it added. And now if you want to make the password as variable, what you can do is we'll create a object called, we'll import the get pass first, import get pass, from get pass from get pass import get pass, then password equal to get pass, then here we'll call the variable password. We'll try to execute the script again. Python, it is asking for password. We'll give the password. Yeah, it configured the device. In this video we have seen how to use send command method and send config set method. So in the upcoming videos we'll be seeing how to SSH to multiple devices, SSH to list of devices from a text file, then push the configuration from a text file and handle the errors in SSH and other authentication error using Netmiko. So I hope this video was helpful for you to understand basics of Netmiko. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.